Welcome to another Daily Dose of Drupal. Today we're on episode number 30. And today we're going to be talking about the Quick Tabs module. The Quick Tabs module is a great solution if you need to take some different blocks and create various tabbed content. So this could be a view, a block, a node, or even other Quick Tabs. And you can use it to create tabbed content which you can easily page through on a Drupal site. So we're going to just show a quick example of this, and there's a couple different designs you can choose from, and you can of course build your own different Quick Tabs designs, but we'll go ahead and we'll start from the beginning, and we'll start by downloading the Quick Tabs module. So now that we have the Quick Tabs module downloaded, we will come here to the modules page. And you can see it does require Chaos Tools, so make sure you have that downloaded and installed. And we're going to turn on both the Quick Tabs and the Quick Tabs Styles module. So you go ahead and click Save on that. And if we scroll down and find the Quick Tabs module again in this list, you can see that there's various configuration pages. So I'll go ahead and I will go to the Quick Tabs page. There's a Quick Tabs and a Quick Tabs style. So it shows you the various different styles that you can choose from: arrows, basic, bullets, Excel, Garland, Mac, nav list, you know, all the way through. We'll go ahead and we'll leave it at arrows. And you can also go into now list Quick Tabs, which this is available just going through a structure, clicking Quick Tabs, and you get to the Quick Tabs page. So we're going to go ahead and click Add Quick Tabs Instance here. And we'll say the renderer, we want it to be Quick Tabs. You could have it be accordion or UI tabs. Here you can select the style, and as we saw on the Styles tab, it shows you the various options. We'll go with arrows. And now you have an option of whether you want to use Ajax to load the tabs or not. If you select yes, then it will only load the default tab when you go to the page. Then when you click on the Quick Tabs tab, it will go ahead and do an Ajax call to load that content dynamically. This will of course make it faster on the initial load, but each click will cause a little bit slower because it has to go ahead and use Ajax to call and pull down that content. But it also means that your initial call requires a little bit less information to be passed back to the browser. Selecting no will go ahead and load everything on the initial page view and just hide those other tabs. So really, it's up to you. There's different, depending on what's displaying in the tabs and your website, you may want to change that, but I'll go ahead and say no, let's load all the tabs on the page view. You can also select this checkbox, which will hide any tabs if they're empty. So if you have a specific view that the person doesn't have permission to, you could go ahead and select this, and that tab won't even show up as an option because it will render as an empty tab. We can go through here and you can select all these different blocks that are available on your website. So we can go ahead and let's just call this one search, and we'll grab the search form. And I'm just finding some examples here, and this is a tab type of a block. If we wanted to use a view, we could select view here, or we could select other Quick Tabs, which there aren't any other Quick Tabs right now. We'll go ahead and we'll look at a specific node on the site. If we go here, you can see that there's a test article in here, and if you hover over the edit tag and look down here at the bottom, you can see that it's node 20, but we'll go ahead and we'll select node and we'll put in 20 as the node ID. You can hide the title, you can make it a teaser view, but we'll just put test article. And we can go ahead and we can add another one. And we could do a view. or we'll just go ahead and do another block just as an example. We don't really have any views on this that would work very well. So you can go ahead and you can select the navigation menu, for instance. We'll just put navigation. So we'll go ahead and click save. Pretty basic so far. You're just building a list of, you know, in this case we have two blocks and one node that we want to display in a QuickTabs instance. Now if we go to the blocks page, and let's say we want to find this QuickTab in here, and I call it Test QuickTabs, we can put this in, we'll go the content section. And it's just like any other block at this point. You can put it in any region in your theme. We, of course, could limit this to only show up on specific pages, or if you're using something like panels, you could display it in a panel. In this case, we're just going to use the standard block system. Go back to the home page. You'll notice now we have QuickTab showing up. So this is how QuickTabs will render. It's using the arrow style. And as you can see, it brings in this test article. Navigation brings in the navigation menu, which is the same as over here. And you can see it's very easy to easily create tabbed content. I can easily come back to this QuickTab, click Edit, and change the style to, we'll say, Mac. Click Save. Come back to the homepage, and now you can see the tabs have changed and it still works just as it did before. Super easy to create various different types of tabbed content for display inside in just a regular block or inside a panel. Very useful when you want to display data going across horizontally. It's something that I've used in dozens of different websites for various purposes, and I'm sure you'll find a use for it as well. So thanks for watching the Daily Dose of Drupal and learning a little bit about the Drupal 7 QuickTabs module. As always, I'm Shane. You can follow me on Twitter at smthomas3, or you can go to codekarate.com and sign up for the newsletter. Thanks again for watching, and we'll be back again tomorrow with another Drupal topic.